Hello, my name is Fabian Labatt, AWS Principal Solutions Architect. In this video, I'll show you how to use Resource Access Manager new Customer Managed Permissions. With Customer Managed Permissions, you can tailor access to specific SHA functions or tasks and follow least privileged best practices by configuring fine-grained access control to your shared resources. In my example, I'll use AWS Resource Access Manager to share an IP address manager pool from account A, the owner of the IPAM pool, with account B, a development account that can create VPCs using the IP address allocations from the shared pool. I'll use a customer managed permission that allows the development account to allocate IP ranges, but does not allow viewing the shared IPAM full details like pool size or utilization. Let's start from account A, the owner of the IPAM pool. I already created the IPAM and pools I'll use in my demo. I'll be sharing a pool I designated to use in development VPCs. From this account, I can see and manage all pool details. To create the customer managed permission and resource share, I navigate to the AWS Resource Access Manager console. Select Manage Permissions Library from the left menu and click the Create Customer Managed Permission button. I provide a name for the permissions we are creating. Select the resource type the permission applies to, in my case, IPAM pool. And in the policy template section, using the visual editor, I'll select only the actions I want to allow in the permission. In my case, I want development accounts to allocate pool ranges, but don't get information about existing allocations or available ranges. I click Create Customer Managed Permission to complete the process. I am now ready to create the resource share. From the AWS Resource Access Manager console left menu, select Resource Shares under the Share by Me section. Click Create Resource Share button. Provide a name for your share. In my case, I'll name it IPAM Share Dev Pool. From the Resource Type dropdown, select IPAM Pools. And then select the IPAM pool we want to share with the other accounts. Click Next. I'll select the customer managed permission we created previously from the Manage Permissions dropdown. I'll confirm the statement and click Next. I am sharing the resource with accounts in my organization. And for my example, I'll share the IPAM pool with the development account specifically. Click Next and review the resource share details. And to complete the process, click Create Resource Share. Let's now sign in to account B, our development account. To confirm that the share IPAM pool is available in account B, under the Share with Me section, I select Resource Shares in the Resource Access Manager console. Now I can create a new VPC and use an IP allocation from the share pool. In the VPC console, click the Create VPC button. I select VPC only, a name for my VPC, and for side block, I use the IPAM allocated option. Confirm that I'm using the shared IPAM pool, choose a netmask size, and finalize the creation process by clicking the Create VPC button. The VPC was successfully created in the development account. Now I want to confirm the customer managed permission I created works as expected. Still from account B, I go to the IPAM console and click Pools in the left menu. I receive an error and I'm not able to see the pool sided blocks or the pool details. The customer managed permission is working as expected. Actions and conditions in customer managed permissions can be modified. To modify the permission, you create a new version and then update the resource share to use the new permission version. Let me show you how to add a condition to the customer managed permission we created in account A, the IPAM owner account. From the Resource Access Manager console, go to the Manage Permissions library. Go to the Manage Permissions detail page, and under the Manage Permission Versions section, click Create Version. The current version does not include a condition. We'll add a condition using the JSON editor. Our condition will check whether multi-factor authentication was used to validate the security credentials making the request. After adding the condition statement, click Create Version. Now, we need to update the resource share to use the new permission version. Go to the resource share and click modify or update to default version. Click update to default version again, complete the wizard, and click update resource share. Let's go back to account B and test the condition. I'm logged in to account B without multi-factor authentication. I try to create a new VPC, select VPC only, select IPAM allocated CIDR block, select my IPAM pool, a netmask, and create VPC. As expected, the creation failed. Let's try now logged in with multi-factor authentication. Go to the VPC console, create VPC, select VPC only, select IPAM allocated CIDR block, my netmask, and create VPC. The VPC creation was successful. With customer managed permissions, you can now use AWS Resource Access Manager to author fine-grained resource access control for supported resource types, following the best practices of least privilege by granting only the permissions required to perform a task. Thank you.